Voilà. That should have fixed the walkway. Monsieur Laclos was the Duc d'Orléans' faithful retainer. He was to prepare the way for his takeover, and now he has become one of the king's most bloodthirsty automats. How ironic.
What of your plan to go to the Bastille?
I haven't yet reached...
Keep making your...
Who laid on this blood-stained mattress?
Oh, it's a strange story. I suppose you heard about what happened in Place Dauphine?
Indeed. I went there.
Well, we took in one of the survivors of the massacre. The only survivor, it seems. Despite his serious injuries, he was particularly talkative.
What did he tell you?
He kept saying that Lafayette was a traitor in the king's pay. That the flaxen-haired hero had deliberately handed his brand new National Guard over to the automats.
What evidence did your guest have?
Nothing substantial, unfortunately. It was based on a simple rumor that was circulating in the camp shortly before the Royal Army attacked. It would appear that several volunteers carried a yellow cartridge in their cartridge pouches. Most likely, a subtle way for the conspirators to recognize each other. The subsequent disaster would tend to confirm this hypothesis. Vous ne croyez pas?
These are suspicions. Nothing more.
Right you are. Oh, if only I had proof of this conspiracy. Then I'd be able to scutter the ambitions of that cur Lafayette for good. The would-be dictator's plans would be foiled.
I must get to the bottom of this urgently.
Very well. I encourage you to do so. But remember that the Marquis could not have acted alone. If you can't find anything implicating him, look into the members of his staff. Start in Place Dauphine, where those brigands sullied the ground with their boots.
Monsieur Marat, Did you take part in an operation that aimed to kidnap the Dauphin and his sister Charlotte?
Me take part in an operation? Nonsense. My only weapon is my pen, and I have sharpened it, believe you me. That said, we did receive some information concerning the children. Unfortunately, I'm sworn to secrecy. If such an operation did indeed take place, Monsieur de Leclos would have been the one behind it. Alas, I fear that he is no longer of this world. There is little doubt that he and his men fell in the galleries.
Dites-moi, Monsieur Marat. What exactly are you doing hiding in a quarry?
I've made a lot of enemies. In my publications, I have always denounced the corrupt and those who corrupt them. These vampires who cheat the weak and bleed the nation dry. Chief among them? That crook, Lafayette. That Trens Sabre. A career soldier who thinks he's Caesar. Not content to maintain an army of rats, this Blondin has all the Châtelet's judges in his pocket. It seems my prose upset him, as he swore to hunt me down. If I hadn't fled, I'd have been done for, there's no doubt about that.
Who are your compagnons?
Patriots who come and go in the quarries throughout the city, under the command of Monsieur Leclos. Alas, there are few left. And I wager that it won't be long before the machines that have taken over our hiding place find me. My hours are numbered. Mais vous-même, have you found any companions for yourself?
Members and supporters of the Third Estate have gathered at the Cordelier Convent.
Would you be so kind as to name them?
In addition to Monsieur de Robespierre, the Comte de Mirabeau is there.
Le Flambeau de Provence. An artful chameleon who skillfully dons every color of the rainbow.
The Marquis de Lafayette, Monseigneur de...
Say no more. They're just the privileged class celebrating the marriage of cowardice and treason. With adversaries like them, the king is sure to triumph.
Who is Monsieur de Leclos?
A brilliant writer whose pen has shaken the old world, but is also an experienced military engineer who has sworn his sword to our common cause, to his great misfortune, it would appear. There is little doubt that he died leading his men through the tunnels.
Thank you.
Look, Chloe, you're alive.
A platoon. Ready.
Fire at will.
Oh, senor.
Oh, we can't stop them. They're upon us. Fixed bayonets. Fixed bayonets!
The fighting has stopped. It's over. Voyez? The Huntress Diana appeared to us. She's the one who saved you.
But the troops? Where are the troops?
You are the only survivor, Laclos.
No.
No. We were so close. But those machines... An entire battalion would have been unable to defeat them. We were forced to retreat. Chased into these tunnels by the automats.
It was madness to attempt an attack on the Bastille.
You're wrong. I'm a military man. It was a bold maneuver, but it was a calculated risk. After all, that old fortress is a pile of stones with no buffers, curtain walls, or bastions. As for its garrison, our agents were certain. Only a handful of veterans should have been there. A single charge should have sufficed to disperse them. But the king made other arrangements. He increased the fortress's defenses and placed a swarm of automats at the service of a terrible machine.
Why did you launch this attack?
Three of our companions were held captive in the fortress. Our best agents.
Agents?
Spies, if you prefer. We, the supporters of the Duc d'Orléans, have always worked in the shadows, within the Queen's entourage, in the tribunes of the Estates General, among the patriots in the clubs, amidst the rank and file in the army.
We have had some success, you have to admit.
What machinations have you discovered?
Enough to make Monsieur Marat's ink flow and bring down our rivals. Necker's speculations, Lafayette's dishonorable behavior, Mirabeau's corruption, and many darker secrets.
Such as Lafayette's plot to rescue the Dauphin and his sister Charlotte.
How on earth do you know that?
She seems as well informed as we are. Once again, the king has won.
That won't always be the case. But right now I have something urgent I must do. Why did you launch
three of
agents?
Spun within the...
We have had...
What machinations?
Enough, Necker's spec... And many.
It was my...
You're wrong. After... As for... As the king... He
Tell me about this machine that got...
We were prepared to face an enemy, not an executioner. That thing, half butcher's block, half stocks, was designed to make heads roll.
Why did you launch this...
Three of our companions...
Agents?
Spies, if you prefer, within the Queen's entourage.
We have had some success, yeah.
What machination?
Enough to make Necker's speculations, and many dark...
Who captured you, Monsieur?
There was some confusion in the fray, but Cagliostro was in charge. He was the one who ordered me to be shut up in that coffin. Then I was thrown into that awful place where I lost consciousness. After that, everything is a series of blurred visions with a voice that ordered me to kill again and again.
I intend to enter the Bastille and free Monsieur de Vaucanson.
For what possible reason, mon Dieu?
She claims that he's the only one who can stop the machines.
Indeed, it's possible. In that case, if you're ready to face the abomination that blocked my path and slaughtered my lieutenants, then don't waste a second. Let's not stay here much longer, Mara. Let's head back to our burrow. There's still some wine left in this part.
More than enough, Laclau. More than enough.
Wonderful. We'll drink to our broken dreams until this finally comes to an end.
Here you are at last. This is where the path to the Bastille begins. And to think, I would have never thought you'd make it this far. Cependant, I would advise you not to rush. The fighting in these tunnels has weakened the structure. If you go in there, I'm afraid you won't be able to turn back. Delor, I have just one bit of advice to give you. Before going any further, make sure you're not leaving behind any unfinished business. Any commitments that you have not fully met. I shall return to my hiding place. In these unsure times, you can never be too careful. Ne croyez-vous pas?
Monsieur le Marquis.
I'm listening, Aegis.
General. There is an alarming rumor about you going around.
Huh. Just one, is there?
You are accused of having delivered the troops who had gathered in the Place Dauphine over to the king.
Calumny. This is nothing less than vile slander. I am the staunchest opponent of the bloodthirsty tyrant who claims to rule us. What's more, I did not call for the uprising. The National Guard came together on their own. This was the work of soldiers who rebelled and called on the people to rise up and defend Paris. It was only after they had gathered that the troops asked me to lead them. Alas, I was too late. But tell me, where did you hear this rumor?
I cannot tell you that, General.
No matter. It's of no importance. I know my enemies, and they are wasting no time. The day will come when I shall make them pay.
I spoke with Monsieur Marat and Monsieur Laclos.
Ah, the scoundrels. Did you force them to confess? Do you know what they did with the children?
They admitted to organizing the ambush at Gros Caillou.
Cursed recreants. Cowardly corruptors of innocence. Where are they holding their prisoners? They must be rescued immediately.
They do not have Charlotte and the Dauphin.
Excuse me? They dare to claim that?
It is the truth. The ambush was a catastrophe. The king had gotten wind of your plans. Automats from Versailles slaughtered the kidnappers and seized the children. By now, the children will have been reunited with their father. There is little doubt about that.
Mon Dieu. Then it is from the clutches of that tyrant, in his own palace, that they must be saved. I fear that such an undertaking is doomed to failure, although there is no question of giving up.
Goodbye, Monsieur le Marquis. Not even the commanding officer was spared. Lafayette didn't hand over his army to the king. I should keep looking around Place Dauphine. Colonel Armand. He died in the attack. Yellow cartridges. The conspirator's secret sign. There was most certainly a conspiracy. There's no doubt about that. But those involved shared the same fate as the rest of them. A headquarters at the Pont au Change. By all appearances, it's not official. Most likely an underground hiding place that can be entered from the riverbank. I'll try to track down Capitaine Lefebvre. If he and his men withdrew to the Société des Amis des Noirs, he must have gone towards the Châtelet. It would have been a desperate move for certain. I doubt any of them survived the retreat. This gate has a lock that requires some combination of four letters. I should follow Capitaine Lefebvre's footsteps. He and his men withdrew to the Société des Amis de Noir. They must have gone towards the Châtelet. I doubt they survived their retreat.